If all the fallen pieces hit the ground, I see it in your eyes.
I'm so lucky to have you.
Oh no!
There was a bug in your eye.
A story speaks and silences my doubt. The wind may blow, but he's built this house. Your voice so soft and strong.
Written by Quinn, can you read it? No, it's my head. No, my head. It is. I mean, everyone else, I just did it because of the show.
Any of you guys,
right?
Yeah,
that's really nice.
That's awesome. Thanks.
And I laid down everything, every part of me.
Wow.
I'm yours.
Every day. You have tears, I'm gonna have tears. No, I'm not.
Through everything, here we stand. Our love's a steady tide. A story speaks and silences my doubt. The wind may blow, but it's built this.
You can put it in your pocket.
So soft and strong, my husband all alone, our love's a steady song. And I laid down everything, every part of me, I'm yours, oh.
I've
waited for the love to come the last time, praying for a soul.
Wow, you look so good.
Look at you. It's so exciting. The day's finally
yes,
here.
Together, not apart.
Thank
there
you.
Is a little card. You might need your glasses.
Oh, that's so sweet. Thank you. Oh, that's beautiful.
And it just has.
Oh, thank you.
I think I'll have to wear it tonight.
Well, it's been a lot of fun.
Before you guys can come in and start your journey to see the bride, you have to pay the entrance fee, one red packet for each bridesmaid, please.
For each bridesmaid.
I only have one.
What? I gave you guys 10.
Where did you guys go? What?
You're gonna have to transfer this piece of seaweed mouth to mouth from the start to the end.
To the end.
Yeah, you're gonna get the foggiest.
Whatever
you prefer.
Not use
the tongue.
I want it to win.
That was so lip to lip.
Three, two, one.
Dance, people.
Yeah, let's be
groovy.
Wait,
is this
with it?
There is going to be words
Close your eyes, make a wish, and look out the candlelight. For tonight is just your night. We're gonna celebrate.
Can we turn that louder?
Through the night, pour the wine.
Pour the wine.
Light the fire.
I'm dancing.
Your little wish is my command. I submit to your demands. And I will do anything. Your need only ask, I'll make love to you.
I started writing it 100 days from our wedding. There are some days missing. When it got a little stressful and busy, I slacked a little bit on the days, but it's from 100 days out. And every single day it's like a countdown, and it's just all my feelings and emotions up until today. And then I wrote this yesterday. I don't know. Wait, this
is it. Yeah. Michelle. You will keep today's ceremony in your minds and in your hearts as one of the most important days of your lives, because in Christ's presence and before his altar, you want to take vows. The vows of love and faithfulness for your entire lives. You have probably already attended many weddings, but this one is different, because finally you are the groom and the bride. As a couple, you had lots of time, many opportunities to practice how to keep your own personalities, how to respect each other, and how to express your love. And as we are in this church, we all know this is not that easy. My first advice for both of you, keep your own personalities, your differences, because they create for both of you that what we would call a mutual enrichment, something that makes your relationship so special and rich. Now we are looking to the future with deep hope, and I have absolutely no doubt that you love each other. I got to know you in this process of preparation for the sacrament of marriage. I was very pleased to learn that you got to know each other for so long. 15 years, it's really, really long time, and dating for 10 years. I can imagine that in this period of time, you had many ways to express your love for one another. Maybe it was a box of chocolate, a bouquet of flowers, a song, a poem, a kiss, a hug. But at the end of the day, you know that none of them will make justice to really express how you feel in your heart, how the other person makes you feel so special. Quinn and Michelle, one of the greatest things that you can give to one another, it's not a material thing, it's actually your word. Some people are very excessive with their words, and they can promise you whatever you want. The sun, the moon, the stars, you name it. But then you learn quickly that you cannot rely on the word. And you know how painful it is to be with such people. But on the other hand, there are people who use their words carefully. And when they make a promise, you can be 100% sure that they will honor it. And you know how lovely it is to deal with such people. Today, Quinn and Michelle, you are giving your word to one another. Not just any word. You are giving your wedding vows. And you are giving those vows not just for a couple of years, but for the rest of your lives. Today, you will make that solemn covenant of your love in front of God's altar. And I'm sure, I'm positive, that the Lord will confirm and seal your promise. He is the one who wants to give you the grace of what we call genuine love. In a moment, you are going to exchange your wedding rings. And these rings will remind you of what you have promised here, October 27, 2023, St. Patrick's Church. These rings will remind you that you promised here your love, your fidelity, and unity. As we gather in this church, we all want to wish you just beautiful moments in life. Quinn and Michelle, have you come here to enter into marriage without coercion, freely and wholeheartedly?
I have.
Are you prepared, as you follow the path of marriage, to love and honor each other
For as long as you both shall live.
I am.
I am.
Are you prepared to accept children lovingly from God and to bring them up according to the law of Christ and His Church?
I am.
I am.
Since it is your intention to enter the covenant of holy matrimony, join your right hands and declare your consent before God and His Church.
I, Quinn, take you, Michelle, to be my wife. I promise to be faithful to you in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health, to love you and to honor you all the days of my life.
I, Michelle, take you, Quinn, to be my husband. I promise to be faithful to you in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health, to love you and to honor you all the days of my life.
May the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob, the God who joined together our first parents in paradise, strengthen and bless in Christ the consent you have declared before the Church, so that what God joins together, no one may separate. The blessing of the rings. May the Lord bless these rings. You will give each other as a sign of love and fidelity.
Amen.
Michelle,
receive this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father,
in the name of the Father,
the Son,
and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Quinn.
Receive
this ring
as a sign of my love and fidelity.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Thank you.
please stand. My brothers and sisters, it is my privilege and my honor to introduce to all of you, husband and wife, and you may kiss each other.
Congratulations,
Aaron.
Drink tea. miss me, or else you'll have to miss me. I guess I'm stuck forever by the good, won't you?
Is the maid of honor, Jessica, to come up and do her first thing.
got non-alcoholic. Testing, testing. Oh, that's loud. All right. Hello. Hope everyone is enjoying the night so far. I'm Jessica, the maid of honor for tonight. And let me tell you, I hate public speaking. You can probably hear it in the quiver of my voice. But for these two, here I am today to share with you a little bit about my best friend, Michelle, and a tad bit of Quinn. Michelle and I first met and became friends in grade 8. We were in the same homeroom and continued to be in the same homeroom for the next 4 to 5 years. We graduated high school together. I went to my first concert with her. I introduced her to paninis. She introduced me to Singaporean curries and beef noodle soup. And we even started our first day of university together and even walked down convocation together. It was always nice doing these big milestones with each other close by for support. And now I'm watching Michelle do the next big milestone with Quinn and leading the way. So taking you guys back to our high school and university days, where we got to see each other essentially every day and had summers off together, people could describe Michelle and I as joint to the hip. We had similar tastes in music and fashion, and we swore in some instances that we could pass for each other, especially from the back. And when Michelle was closer to my height, but I don't know why, Michelle continued to grow and I just stopped growing altogether. But that's an irrelevant rant. We became so close that we could read each other's minds through silent eye glares or a quick glance across the room. I could also read a lot from her big, beautiful eyes. Together, we developed weird ways of talking, laughing, and noise making. And if you know Michelle and I, you know we like to sigh a lot and also make gag noises if something were to gross us out or displease us. Quinn was also in our homeroom. And I would say that this is when their sparks started to develop. And over time, I started to notice Michelle's pattern in boys. Her typical type, and continues to be, pale. Tall, scrawny or lanky, slightly awkward, in a cute way, I guess, and most importantly, funny. Some of her other crushes and obsessions during this time were Michael Cera, Jesse Eisenberg, and Edward Cullen. And holy heck, was she over the top obsessed with Edward Cullen and the Twilight saga? I think she once mentioned she physically cried because she could not be in a relationship with said vampire. And luckily, her and I never had the same crushes, or let alone ever had to compete for the same man's attention. And as you can tell by my man, her and I have a completely different taste and flavor profile. And for those who don't already know, it's Quinn's best man, my big and brown, handsome boyfriend over there, giving you guys a wave. And also, apologies for gagging in the mic, but it wouldn't be a speech dedicated to Michelle if I didn't. On the flip side, Quinn and I would chat often on MSN or Skype back in the day. And one thing that I always admire and still do is his knack for callbacks, quick movie or TV show references, and his ability to send clips that were sometimes so niche, but fit the moment or the conversation perfectly. But what is endearing about Quinn and this relationship is that Michelle was also always on his radar. I'm sure the Carney gang here can vouch that we all knew they had a big secret crush on each other, but couldn't bring themselves to admit it to one another until much later on. So it's textbook that these two high school lovebirds are finally tying the knot. They really gave me the high school experience of the drama, the romance, the ahs, the oh no's, the overthinking, sometimes the underthinking, Quinn. And the I don't think they like me backs, so on and so forth. But here we finally are, and we are all very much excited to see you guys in the next chapter together. So I'd like to raise a toast and my biggest congratulations to the bride and groom. Cheers.
Thank you, Jessica, for bringing up some of our other old-time memories. I don't know if I'm in the right place to say this or not, but I'm going to say it anyway. So we're going to introduce Mr. Big and Brown next to finish off and see if we can top his our speech. So, please.
Hello. Sorry, I have the same fears of public speaking as my partner Jessica, so I hope I can do half as well as she did up here. And let me tell you, I'm a crier. So, yeah. If you don't know, Quinn was crying earlier today, so I feel like I'm okay to cry. Yeah, I'm okay to cry too. So, well. Usually they only let me speak at funerals, so this is a good change of pace for me, speaking about love and life. So thank you for having me. Thank you for having me. So hello, everyone. For those of who don't know me, my name is Naveen Sachidanandan, and I'm the best man for the evening. So I know that Quinn no doubt chose me for this honor because we have gotten into a little bit of that and a little bit of this back in the day. When I say this and that, I do it to A, be as vague as possible so as to not include anything from the do not mention list, and B, because over the years, Quinn and I have spent so many valuable moments together that it is impossible for me to condense 15 years of friendship into 4.5 more minutes, I think. I got a little bit of time, right? But before I get to Michelle and Quinn, I just want to put a little bit of a spotlight on the groomsmen. I know they weren't expecting anything, but I'm going to talk a little bit about them too. Other than Quinn's brother, who's in the groomsmen party, Dallin is the groomsman that has known him for the longest time. Yeah. They went to Queen of All Saints Elementary School for a few years before heading to Kearney, where we all eventually met. And if you can believe it, their friendship started all the way back before the first iPhone. What feels like centuries ago, they were friends. And now they're old enough and mature enough to ponder how the next big app will use AI CPAs to do your taxes for you using only the most advanced Excel shortcuts in the world. I'm selling an app. Keep your wallets open. So, I'll move on to John. John. He was at one point Quinn's roommate when they lived together at Quinn's Suderbrook apartment. They share a similar love for film, television, sports, gaming, and music. Though we all know that you can't let John DJ for too long unless you want to hear remixes of the Super Smash Brothers soundtrack or the Venga Boys. And for those of you who don't know who the Venga Boys are, I think you'll know what I mean when I talk about the old man from the Six Flags commercials. John has played that at every single get-together we have ever had, ever. Go home and Google it, please. Next up, we have Dylan. So, him and Michelle's relationship is something very special. And I don't think that a lot of younger brothers can say they have as strong of a bond with their older sister as these two. I should know, I have an older sister around the same age gap, and we aren't nearly as close, jovial, or warm. I say this because I know I would definitely never go on a Disneyland trip with my sister's friend group, but he did. And he was a huge factor in why the trip was a success, and we all had an amazing time together. So thank you, Dylan. So, you might be wondering, has Dylan's example helped inspire me to call my sister more and do more? Not really, no. But I know I will give her a big hug, thanks to you. Next time I see her. So, but to be really honest with you, deep down, I always wanted an older brother. But Quinn's got plenty of those. And his brother, Braden, was in our groomsmen party as well. After spending some time with him, it's really hard to differentiate who is who. They both make the same kind of jokes. They have similar cadences. They play hockey on the same team. And they both married way out of their league. I don't know how they did it. Quinn, you could say, is just the tall, beardless version of his brother. Right? And hey, if I had to choose an extra couple inches or my beard, I'm choosing my beard. It doesn't matter. So I'm on your side, Braden. Don't worry. But to be honest, if there was a genie here offering free trips to Turkey for a hair transplant or a beard, I'd have to sleep on it. I don't know what I'd choose. I think I might need a new head of hair. So, finally, on to the bride and groom. I first want to say thank you so much for having Jessica and I be part of your wedding party. We were crushed to miss out on Singapore, but we're so excited to be here with you guys today. Marriage is definitely different than just being with someone for a long time. And I'm looking forward to seeing how you two flourish as husband and wife in the years to come. To think that the catalyst for all of this, all of these people here, and this event, all started with a kiss at a party is crazy for me to think about. I was actually there with Quinn moments before and after the kiss happened. Not during. That's just weird. I wasn't there during the kiss. That was a private moment between them two. But it happened in a dark, empty park during a Halloween party. Just like how all good horror movies start. It's today. Their first kiss anniversary is today. So, you know what? I forgot my glass, so let me just grab that real quick. Sorry about that. John, could you hand that to me? Oh, thank you. Sorry, my toast is coming up. I'm almost done. Sorry. Sorry. So, I was there to hype him up before the kiss and also there to celebrate once he got back. So, to keep it real, I don't remember exactly what was said, but I can still feel the excitement he portrayed in that moment. Quinn's love for Michelle has been unwavering ever since, and I'm so happy to have been a witness to it since its inception. That night kicked off a first of many firsts that followed, and now that you two are married, you can share in all of those firsts again. There's a famous wedding quote that basically says that a successful marriage requires you to be continuously falling in love with the person that you're with. I know what I saw that night of their first kiss, and I know what I saw I know that I saw the exact same thing during the ceremony earlier today. With all that being said, I'd like to raise a toast to the newlyweds. We all wish you two a long and happy marriage, and we'll be by your sides for more firsts, and we will no doubt be part of more of things like this, and we will get into a little bit more of that, whatever that may be. Cheers. Thank you.
Okay, now that we have the two friends that came by and shared the special moments with them throughout their life, we're gonna bring out the parents, the two fathers to be exact. They're gonna explain from a point of view since they were babies of what they think, how they feel, and moving on from this day on how it goes. So first off, we're gonna go back to who introduced you all to the bridesmaids and grooms. Give it up for Wayne.
Wow. For people that don't like to public speak, I mean, come on. I gotta follow that? I mean, seriously. I don't like it either, okay? Actually, first of all, I'd just, of course, like to congratulate the bride and groom. Long time planning, lots of hard work, and look at this, it's turned out so well. So, congratulations. I'd also like to congratulate the Pangs. Al and Evelyn, you've raised a lovely daughter. I'm sure you're proud tonight and always. And I also want to say thank you to you for welcoming Quinn into your home. I know he's there a lot. So, you know, so thank you very much. And you treat him like a son, and I really appreciate that. I have notes in my pocket, but I'm going to try to just... Michelle? I can remember the first time we met 10 years ago or so. You know, you and Quinn had just graduated. You know, you're starting your life together. You were going to Simon Fraser. And we would remember I would come up sometimes and pick you up and we'd go for dinner. And, you know, Browns and Coquitlam, crazy waitress, all sorts of like weird stuff sort of thing. So it was that was a time I really got to know you, and I saw how you two were together. And you know, I knew that Quinn had chosen well, and, you know, it's where I first started to fall in love with you as well, so. And Quinn, what can I say? Quinn, let's see. Youngest of four boys. Tallest of four boys. He says, of course, best looking of four boys, but I don't know about that. I think they're all pretty handsome, so. Anyway, most of you know Quinn, probably know that he loves playing hockey. Besides Michelle, he loves hockey, he loves playing. So I think some of his teammates may be here actually tonight, so they can attest to that. But I'm not sure a lot of people know how his hockey career began, so I'm gonna tell you. Quinn is about maybe 5 or 6, and his, of course, his older brothers all played hockey, so it was kind of a natural that he would give it a go. I mean, we had a lot of equipment, right? So I was like, may as well give it a go, right? So, but he hadn't really been on the ice very much. He wasn't very good at skating. He hadn't really handled the puck that much. So I thought, you know what? I think his mother, Denise, found some sort of a hockey camp before the season started, and we thought, let's put him in this camp. We'll get him, you know, he'll learn how to skate, and it'll really help out. But I may have not have read the fine print on this ad, or I kind of don't always read all the words on a page, so that may have been the thing, but this camp was for, like, elite 5- and 6-year-old hockey players. So we had no idea, you know. Anyway, his mother brings him to the rink and kind of gets him all dressed up, and all these kids are skating circles around. They're passing the puck. It looks like the Canucks practice, apparently, right? So she's like, oh, well, what am I going to do? So kind of dresses him up, gets him to the edge, opens the gate for him to go on. Quinn steps out. Boom. Right on his face. Meanwhile, she can't help. She's like, I can't go out on the ice, so... somebody comes over, one of the young coaches or something, helps him up, and anyway, his mother has to leave, and he's on his own. So, meanwhile, then phones me, and I go, how's it going? She's like, not good. Not good. That's all she could say. I was like, oh boy. So, I think, okay, you know what? We're not going to have 4 hockey players. He can play soccer, you know, maybe lacrosse, baseball, or whatever. He's going to hate it. So, anyway, I get home that night, and I come over and like, hey, Quinn, how did it go? Huh? And I'm expecting tears, of course, but he's like, I loved it. It was so good. I got to do little drills stepping over sticks and skating around cones. And he had his own personal coach for the entire week. They just took him off to the side. He didn't play with the other kids. So that's how his illustrious hockey career began. That also says a lot about how Quinn is. He's always, you know, he was a good kid. He pretty happy-go-lucky, gets along with people. And as an adult, I'd say he's the same. One of the qualities that I always talk about with Quinn, as I always see him, is he's a very thoughtful person. And not just in being kind and caring, but he thinks about things. He sees issues from both sides. He argues issues from both sides sometimes, which is very confusing. But he gives people the benefit of the doubt. And, you know, that's something I really admire in you. And just before I have one more thing I'd just like to share with you. I'm like the other two, where it's like public speaking is not my thing. Standing in front of a crowd, you know, brings great anxiety. And I probably had a lot of anxiety weeks and months before this. As those who know me know. But as it started to approach, you know, I started to feel differently. And I thought, you know, what an honor this is. You know, this is a real honor to be here tonight and speak at this event. Hold on. And say to my son, Quinn, I am so proud of you. I'm proud of the man that you've become. I am really blessed to have you in my life, and I love you. And thank you for this honor. And thank you. So if you could raise your glass to Quinn and Michelle. Love, happiness, and joy tonight and always.
Respect that. Following, we'll do the bride's father, my father, a very respectable man that will come up and share a couple words about these two.
All 4 of us don't like public speaking, so. Unlike Wayne, who's got the notes in his pocket and going to read them. First of all, thank you and everybody for coming to celebrate this with us, with Michelle and Quinn. Yeah. Michelle, our most beloved daughter, we want to let you know, Mommy and I, how precious you are to us. We are so proud of the woman that you've grown up to be. You're so beautiful inside and out. Remember that? And we want you to know how proud we are of the person that you've become and the accomplishments that, the things that you've accomplished. Even that perfectionist side in you, which is mostly a good thing. Mostly. I remember one day she came back from school all upset because she only got 98 marks in her exam. She had to call the professor to find out where she went wrong. But that speaks to what Michelle is and what she stands for, the character that she is. Always striving to be the best that she can be. I've also read the thesis that she has written in school. And I'm always so amazed at the depth of her writings, the passion and the care in everything that she does. I'm sure the kids that you tailor the programs for are gonna be so lucky. Today is the perfect opportunity for us to tell you how proud we are of you. And I'm beaming as a dad and mom there too. And so proud of Michelle. From the moment you came into this world, we are thankful and grateful that we have been blessed with a beautiful and amazing daughter. Most of you probably are not aware of this, but Michelle is not only smart, but she's a fantastic ballerina. She can ballet, tap, jazz. I remember very fondly when she was about 2 years old. She was sitting at the piano. I had the music playing. And she was just playing along with the tune and dancing along with it. Just picture an enthusiastic baby Elton John at the piano, and that's what it looked like. We look back and reminisce the joy we shared in her growing up years, and it truly fills our hearts with joy over the times we've shared. That was then. We love you then, we love you now, and even when you're 50, Michelle, you'll still be our baby girl. We'll always love you. Well, today is the day we officially hand her over to Quinn. Quinn, let me tell you, you're a lucky guy. And good luck. We've had the pleasure of Quinn's company for over 10 years. Like Wayne says, maybe 4 times a week. Good times. When I tell my friends that my daughter's getting married, they ask me, oh, so do you like the guy? I say, you know what? I think I do like him. Phew, right? After all, if our perfectionist daughter chose him, he must be pretty good, right? In fact, we've grown to know Quinn pretty well over the years. He's like family now. Not only are we blessed with our beautiful daughter, and not forgetting our beautiful son, Dylan over there, of course. Now we are blessed with a wonderful and handsome son-in-law. Welcome, son. He's over, like I said, over at our place 3-4 times a week still, even though they've got their apartment. And I welcome that because now I don't have to worry about mummy over there having empty nest syndrome. Quinn is very adventurous, especially eating new foods. He's a daring fella, spice king. But he doesn't like durian. We call him the walking quincyclopedia, saying earlier, yeah, because he's got all this useless information in his head. But yeah, a lot of times it comes in very, very helpful, very helpful. If we need an answer, we just, hey, Quinn! Michelle and Quinn, in the last 10 years together, there have been many ups and downs in your relationship that we've experienced, we've seen. You always managed to overcome them because of the love for each other. We hope that you will continue to bring the best out of each other in this next chapter in your lives. That said, we are so happy to welcome you, Quinn, Wayne, Denise, all the Cahills and all. I've a much bigger extended family now. Thank you. We wish you both happiness, compassion for each other, tolerance. Always treat each other with respect, and most importantly, love each other. Forgot my glass. To the bride and groom, cheers.
I think let's all take a moment of silence to introduce the bride and groom to their first dance together as a couple. Oh, but they also have a word to say. The speeches aren't done? Okay. Let's give them the show now, even though they've been upstage all day, but it's your turn now.
Thank you, Dale. All right, ooh, you're keeping track at home. That's like 7 times I've cried, I don't know. Just gonna keep coming. Well, following 4 people who don't like public speaking is difficult because those were incredible speeches, so can we give it up for all of those? Jeez. But really, me and Michelle are here because we just wanna thank a bunch of people who made this evening possible. As you can tell, a lot of work went into tonight, so there's gonna be a lot of thank yous. It may sound like basically an Oscar speech at some point, so let's hope the band does not play me off. All right, so first, thank you to everyone who came out this evening. It means so much to have each and every one of you here. Me and Michelle cannot express enough how much it means to have all our loved ones here to experience this with us. Especially want to thank people who came from out of town, people who came from Port Moody, no, I'm just kidding, Vancouver Island, Ottawa, Singapore. People came from Singapore to be here. Half the people, okay? Half the people in this room don't know where Singapore is on a map. That's how far it is, okay? So I want to say thank you to Godma, Auntie Sharon, Ipo Evelyn. Thank you so much for being here. It's such a tremendous blessing to have each of you here today. Thank you so much for coming. Next, I want to thank everyone who helped out this evening, put it together. It was a tremendous task. Certainly cannot have done it without the Rosewood Hotel and Oksana for being the main contact we had here. Thank you so much. and our amazing wedding planner, Jennifer. It would have completely come apart at the seams if Jennifer wasn't here. So thank you so much, Jennifer.
Thank you, Jennifer.
Okay. There's Jennifer. Father Mache and St. Patrick's Church, as well as all the vendors, photographers, videographers, pianists, cellists, DJ, you have all made Michelle and I's dream come true this evening. Thank you all so much. And now the wedding party to the bridesmaids. Aren't they looking stunning this evening? Have you seen those dresses? Thank you all for all the crazy number of hours you put into making this an amazing event. Really, you have done everything and more that Michelle has asked, and I have asked, of course. to my groomsmen, thank you for standing with me today and being by my side through thick and thin. You are all my brothers in my heart, or by blood, or by marriage. Thank you so much. I love you guys. To Naveen in particular, my best man, I've known you since I was 13. You would be my best friend. Sorry, one sec. You'd be my best friend on, I don't even know what I'm saying here. All I want to say is in grade 8, what happened once was I was a lonely child who had no lunch, okay? just picture that, how scrawny I am. I was described as scrawny, right? So I had no lunch, and Naveen gave me a pizza pop, okay? He gave me his own pizza pop, and he has not let me forget it to this day. That is as big a sacrifice as you can make for a friend, okay? Thank you for always being someone I can depend on, Naveen. I'm truly honored to have someone as good a person as you to be the best man. I love you, Naveen. Thank you to my family, of course, Mom and Dad. I'm incredibly blessed to have both your unconditional love and support throughout my entire life. Dad, thank you for being my number one supporter since day one. You are the first person I call when something goes wrong. Maybe the second person I call when something goes right. So it's pretty good, right? Mom, your boundless love, strength, and resolve inspires me and makes me proud to be your son. I love you both. To my brothers, Jordan, Taylor, Braden, thank you for being my mentors, my friends, and role models throughout my life, and teaching me the importance of not being annoying, or you'll get beat up, and the importance of playing violent video games and movies. But really, thank you for always looking out for me and being the best big brothers anyone could ask for. Thank you. I love you all. And to my new mom and dad, or mommy and daddy, as I should, to be exact, thank you for welcoming me into your family with open arms. Your love and support have meant the world to me, and I couldn't be more grateful to have you as a part of my life. Even if sometimes I struggle to call you mommy and daddy, know that I love you both. Thank you. And now to my wife. I've been waiting since like 2006 to say that, okay? You gotta give me it. I'll keep this short because I don't want to start blubbering again. But words cannot express my love for you. Thank you for choosing me for loving me, and for making me the luckiest man in the world. Here's to us and our journey ahead. Cheers to Michelle, the love of my life. Thank you, everybody.
Hi, everyone. There's been a lot of beautiful speeches, so I'm going to try to keep it short, and I'm going to try to follow it up to the best of my abilities. Quinn has already mentioned and thanked most of the people who helped make this special day possible. I just want to reiterate how grateful I am to have had this day with all of my loved ones. Standing here with all of you, looking back at me, is honestly something that I will never forget and will always feel extremely blessed to have experienced. So thank you all for being here today. Thank you again to all my amazing bridesmaids who helped with all my crazy arts and craft ideas and held my hand when I got stressed, even when I pretended that I was chill. You guys knew that I needed a hug and a hand to hold, so thank you for always being there for me. This day truly couldn't have happened without you guys, so I love you all so much. I especially want to thank Jessica, my maid of honor, who has been such a huge and important part of not just this day, but my whole life. You've been there for me since we were only 13. And 15 years later, you're always still around when I need a hug, through thick and thin. Even after I got mad at you in grade 9 for sitting beside Quinn when you knew I liked him first. Clearly, our friendship has come a really long way, but look at us now. You're so beautiful inside and out. I've said this before, but I feel so grateful that I get to do life with you, and I can't wait for everything else that we're going to experience together. I love you with my whole heart. To my new mom and dad, I just want to say thank you for raising Quinn to be truly the man of my dreams. He's someone I always dreamed of having, and I truly feel so blessed to be loved by him. I promise to always take care of him and love him the way that you always have. Promise. To Dylan, we love you. You already know how much we do. You were the first best friend I ever had, and you will always be someone I trust, love, and admire with my whole heart. Your smile and laugh light up my life. When I was younger, I always wished I had an older brother to protect and take care of me, but I never knew that you'd one day grow up to be everything that I ever dreamed of. I love you. To my mommy and daddy, Mommy and Daddy. You are the first people that I ever loved. You taught me what it means and what it takes to love unconditionally, and you also showed me how that's supposed to feel like. My understanding of love grew from both of you. Growing up, whenever I felt confused about what love was supposed to feel like, I immediately remembered the second you hugged me or told me that everything was going to be okay. Everything I have because of you, and I will never forget that. I will always be your baby girl, even when I'm 50. Love you. Finally, to Quinn, my husband. Can't believe I get to say that now. Loving you and being loved by you has been a roller coaster and a dream come true. I can't believe how lucky I am to have found my best friend and my soulmate all in one. I can't wait to spend every day with you, and there's honestly no one else that I would rather spend my days growing old with. So thank you for always making my life beautiful. I love you. So cheers to all of you here today. Thank you for making this day so special. It'll be a day that we will never forget. Love you. Thank you. Cheers.
For sure, he was sent here from heaven, and I'm daddy's little girl. As he drops to his knees by my bed at night, he talks to Jesus, and I close my eyes, and I thank God for all of the joy in my life. Oh, but most of all, butterfly kisses after bedtime prayer, sticking little white flowers all up in my hair. Walk beside the pony, daddy, it's my first ride. I know the cake looks funny, daddy, but I sure tried. Oh, with all that I've done wrong, I must have done something right to deserve a hug every morning and butterfly kisses at night.
It's a little bit funny, this feeling inside. I'm not one of those who can easily hide. I don't have much money, but boy, if I did, I'd buy a big house where we both could live. If I was a sculptor, but then again, no. Or a man who makes potions in a traveling show. I know it's not much, but it's the best I can do. My gift is my song, and this one's for you. Tell everybody this is your song. It may be quite simple, but now that it's done, I hope you don't mind. I hope you don't mind that I put down the words how wonderful life is while you're in. I hope you don't mind, I hope you don't mind that I put down in the words how wonderful life is while you're in the
Now that that's over and the embarrassment's over, you two will have your first dance together as husband and wife. That's weird to say, but please steal the show.
adrenaline running through my veins and my skeleton. When you say my name and the high, no, it never goes away. I like jumping out of airplanes and swimming with the sharks. That existential feeling when you're staring at the stars. There's a hurricane in my head, but the lightning in my heart makes it worth it. Yeah, I still get nervous when you walk through the door and you look in my eyes. Yeah, it feels like the very first time. I could fall for you forever, I'm certain. 'Cause I still get nervous when your lips hit my lips and the fireworks fly, sending sparks through the air like the 4th of July. I could fall for you forever, I'm certain. 'Cause I still get nervous every time we touch. It's like paradise fell down from above, and the high, even too much ain't enough. No, I like flying in the fast lane, no headlights in the dark. That existential feeling when you wonder what you are. Got a wild wind in my head, but the butterflies in my heart make it worth it. Yeah, I still get nervous when you walk through the door and you look in my eyes. Yeah, it feels like the very first time. I could fall for you forever, I'm certain. 'Cause I still get nervous when your lips hit my lips and the fireworks fly, sending sparks through the air like the 4th of July. I could fall for you forever, I'm certain. 'Cause I still get nervous. Oh, you walk in so perfect and my heart short circuits. No, why I still get nervous when you walk through the door and you look in my eyes. Yeah, it feels like the very first time. I can fall for you forever, I'm certain. 'Cause I still get nervous when your lips hit my lips and the fireworks fly, sending sparks to the air like the 4th of July. I can fall for you forever, I'm certain. 'Cause I still get nervous. I still get nervous.
Thank you.